Hi there. In this video, I'm going to show you some of the various PDF settings options you have when configuring the core templates on your form. So we'll go ahead and add a new PDF on our form. Press the wrong button. So under settings, PDF on your form, hit add new, and then we'll go ahead and add the label. We'll call this contact. Name for the file name. We're going to leave the template set to Zidani. And we're going to head down to the appearance section. So we've got paper size option, defaults to A4. If you're some of our users over in the US, you'll want to usually select letter. We can change the orientation too. By default, it's portrait, but we can go landscape. Appearance tab also allows you to adjust the font. If you had a look at our font video, we talked about the different custom fonts you can install and select. There's also a large number of core fonts that you can use, broken up into language types. We're going to use Free Sans for this, which is a nice Unicode font. Increase the size a little bit. And we might not want the text color quite so harsh. We'll just bump the black down a little bit. I'm going to hit add PDF now. Go and view one of those. So this is a letter landscape document now. The thing I usually do when configuring PDFs on a form is I'll have PDF open in one tab and the settings open in another. Sorry, that was the wrong settings. And the settings open in another. So you can quickly change a setting and update, then refresh that PDF. And now our document is in portrait view. So they're the various appearance settings. If you weren't happy with any of the paper size presets, which are the standard ABC sizes and some common sizes, you can select custom paper size and enter your own in millimeters or inches. I could enter 10.5 inches for the width and make this 20 inches high. And hit update now. And that'll give us a different paper size again. So you've got those options available to you to actually add some brand appeal to the template. The header section's a good option for including a logo. You can use the add media button and select the logo. We might center align this and we'll hit update, refresh. Now we got a nice logo in there. If you want it to be a bit crisper, you can use a larger image size, or if your website supports it, you could even include a SVG file. Just be careful with the SVGs, not all syntax for SVGs are supported, so might need to play around with it a little bit if you're trying to get an SVG to show up. So we've got our logo at the top, center aligned. We could also add additional content in the header, like some contact info or a letterhead. There's a link below. Above the header, if you want to use a column, and click that, I can copy this three column layout HTML to the header. And to do that, I'll select the text tab and I'll paste in the header content, and I'll just put my image in that left column now. I've got the logo in the left column, the form title in the middle, and the date right. And I'll hit update there. And that's just adjusted things. So I've got that column layout there. So you can play around with the header and the footer that way. Other options, and this is going to be template specific. In this particular template, we can adjust the field border. I might want to use a nice little blue color, my borders, to match the logo. And now we've got this nice blue instead of the gray around our field responses. We might want to include HTML fields in the PDF. If there's any HTML fields in the form, that'll then be included in the PDF as well. Background color, we could change away from white if we wanted. Just remember to adjust the font color so there's enough contrast that users can view the or read the text properly on that background. Also add a background image. If you're going to add a background image, I recommend having the image be the same size as the paper you choose. So if you've chosen A4 or you've chosen letter, and make it 210 by 297 millimeter image size, and compress that image first before you upload it and use it. Don't want the PDFs to be too large. You can also add a footer. So I can have my contact info down the bottom here. I might center align that. And I'll refresh now. We've got our footer at the bottom. See a bit of overlap at the top here with the logo now due to the columns. So to fix that, I might just need to adjust the width a bit more. Give him 50% width for this, for the image. Just to get it looking nicer. And adjust the template as well. It's going to give us different designs. These are the templates I've got installed. I'll stick with the core ones for this demonstration. This is focus gravity. This is going to give us much more, a design much more like Gravity Forms print preview. And in this particular template, you can adjust the accent and secondary colors. Change that to a red and change that secondary color a bit more pink. Update. This will change the whole look and feel of the design now. You can play around with those colors to match your branding and get the results you're looking for. That's particular to focus gravity, those two settings, the accent color and secondary color. Format's also particular to that template. So you've got this combined view. We've got this split view where the label and the value are separated by their own colors. And Rubix is, again, different. This is the default format with the gray background, and we can change that color of the container. Let's do a nice little blue hue. I'm gonna use a darker one, darker blue here, just so I can show you about that color contrast on the fonts again. So you can see I can't see the color here with that background, and I would need to adjust the font color to suit. Just what you got to be aware of though is it's going to adjust the font color for everything outside those containers as well. So you have to try and find a middle ground with the color you use, that's going to work in all use cases. We'll go something a bit lighter again, so we can use the black font color. Yeah, that's a bit better. Probably still not color contrast enough for accessibility, but that's something that you'll test and play around with depending on your use case. I might go and adjust the font again. Let's use Roboto. And I'll just default that container background. Go. There's some of the customization tools available.